Hey, shalom, Israel, Most High in Christ. Bless. It's your brother, Captain Azariah, and you tuned in to another edition of 15 Minutes with the Captains. To my right, I got
Officer Abia,
and we're going to get started. So today's topic is endurance till the end. We're going to cover endurance and staying enduring to the end and staying steadfast in His truth. So let's get right into it. Give me Matthew's, the 10th chapter, and we're going to start at verse 22.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 22.
Come on.
And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake.
So the Bible tells us we're going to be hated of all men for Christ's name's sake, for this Bible. For keeping God's commandments, you're going to be hated of all men. Why? Because it's going to set you at odds. You're going to be hated of your family. You're going to be hated of your parents. There's going to be certain trials and tribulations and things that are going to happen to you in your life because of Christ's name's sake, because of the Bible. Because you want to apply God's commandments. But watch this, read.
But he that endureth to the end.
But Christ is letting us know, he that endures to the end. To the end of what? Whether it be death or Christ returns. He that endures to the end. Come on.
Shall be saved.
Shall be saved. Shall be saved. So with that being said, the keys to endurance, the keys for us enduring and staying strong and not bugging out and wigging out and going back into the world was given to us in this Bible. Watch that. Let's start with Sirach, the second chapter. We're going to start at verse 1.
This is Sirach chapter 2, verse 1. My son, if thou come to serve the Lord, prepare thy soul for temptation.
That's the first thought that you need to have whenever you come into repentance. That you need to go ahead and wrap your mind around that when you come to serve the Lord, temptation is coming. Trials, tribulations are coming. This ain't a bed of roses. This ain't peaches and cream like Christianity, like the Christian church. You have to wrap your mind around that. Temptation, trials, tribulation is coming. When you come to serve the Lord, prepare your soul for temptation. Read.
Set thy heart aright.
And in that, you knowing this, you set your heart aright. You meditate on the scriptures. Like Psalm said, day and night. You meditate day and night. You set your heart aright. You apply God's commandments. You don't just be a parakeet and memorize scriptures. You actually apply what you read. Come on.
And constantly endure.
And that's going to help you constantly endure. So when them attacks from Satan come, when them trials and tribulations come, guess what? You're applying the scriptures, so you're able to endure what's coming on. So when that big booty woman come walking by, the scriptures is on your mind, and you're not just a parakeet. You're not just memorizing scriptures just to sound good and look good in front of men. You're actually applying what you have read. So when that big booty woman come walking by, you be like, nah, Matthew 5. Nah, I ain't looking at that. You endure temptation. You endure tribulation. Come on.
And make not haste in time of trouble.
And guess what? When times get troublesome for you, when you're going through those troubles in time, whether it is you about to lose your house or you going through things with your wife, whatever it may be, congregational trials, you're not making haste. That's a part of the endurance. You don't just make haste when in time of trouble. You ain't quick to run when things get hard. Come on.
Verse 3, cleave unto him.
The scriptures tell you to cleave unto him. Who's the him? The Lord. The Bible. This Bible is how you cleave unto the Lord. Come on.
And depart not away.
And you're not running from this Bible. That's real endurance. Regardless of what's going on, you staying firm on the laws of God. Come on.
That thou mayest be increased at thy last end.
And that's how you're going to be increased at your last end. The same shall be saved. He that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. Come on.
Whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully.
And that's something we have to learn, as Israelites, and repented in this truth. The things that are brought upon us, we have to learn to take them cheerfully. Not getting that, because that's what Satan wants. Satan wants you in that depressed, that the spirit's on you, emotional, you all upset because this happened. And I understand, you know, it's tough. You lose your job. Mm-hmm. It's tough. You going through foreclosure and you about to lose your house. Those things weigh heavy on you. But the scriptures tell you, whatsoever is brought upon you, take cheerfully. It ain't in the Bible for no reason. These is a part of us enduring. Because it's real easy for you to wig the hell out and do something that you regret doing whenever you depressed or whenever you at ends meet and you don't know where it's going to come from. So in your mind, you like, F it. No, you take what's come upon you cheerfully. You stay in that gladness of heart and you cleave to the Bible. Read on.
And be patient when thou art changed to a low estate.
That right there keeps you from stealing. That right there keeps you from wanting to rob. It's the scriptures say, be patient when thou art changed to a low estate. Because we only need the chief things of life, bread, food, water, place to cover shame. The Bible talks about that. But because of our lust and our wants and our needs, a lot of times we like to go above our means. Now, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with you having nice things and living and buying nice things and desiring to have nice stuff. That's not what the Bible's talking about. But if you know that ain't you and you are at a lower state, be patient. Don't go out, look, be patient. Understand, the Lord is going to look. If you keeping God's commandments and the faith of his son, the Lord going to look out for you. I know that without a shadow of a doubt from my own experiences. The Lord going to take care of you. The Lord going to look out for you. You just got to make sure you apply the scriptures. And when you brought to that lower state, just be patient. Read on.
Verse 5. For gold is tried in the fire.
Because guess what? You're going through all these things. You're going through these trials, these tribulations. Because there's something in you that you need to fix. Because just like gold, when you go and get gold, when you hit it, you don't just strike pure gold, pure, pure unfiltered, what's the word I'm looking for? Pure, basically pure gold.
Right.
There ain't no impurities in it. You don't just strike a rock and hit pure gold.
Never.
No. It's got all type of impurities in it, like copper and dirt and sand and rock and all type of different other elements. They have to take it and refine it. Gold is tried in the fire. It gets through. It's a fire process that refines gold to get it to that pure state. Just like you. You are that gold. You are that gold that is being tried in the fire. And you have to endure it so that all them impurities, all those sins, all those demons that are on you gets burnt up. So you apply these certain things. Read on.
For gold is tried in the fire, and acceptable men in the furnace of adversity.
And acceptable men in the furnace of adversity. Now watch this. Give me Matthew 5 and 29. Here's another example of endurance. These are the keys. These are steps that you take to make sure that you endure in these truths. Because a lot of times, as men and women, we like to make provisions of the flesh. We like to, you know yourself. We're going to get that scripture too. Like Paul said, know ye not yourself, you know yourself. And a lot of times we like to make provisions for certain things we battle and deal with. But watch what Christ said. Give me Matthew 5, read verse 29.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 29. And if thy right hand offend thee, pluck it out.
Now, read that verse again, read it right.
And if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out.
Now, Christ isn't speaking literal, if your right eye offend thee, go take something. Pluck it out of your eye. That ain't what Christ is talking about for you simple Christians, so-called Christians out there. When he says, if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out, he's talking about whatever is causing you to sin. And we're going to explain that as we read on. Come on.
And cast it from thee, for it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell.
It's profitable that one of your members should perish and not your whole body die and be cast in a lake of fire. Watch this. What is the members talking about? Because the members he's referring to in this context was your right eye. So what is it talking about when it says members? Give me Colossians. Colossians 3 and verse 5. What does he mean? It is profitable for that one of thy members should perish and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell. Read that. Colossians chapter 3 verse 5.
Colossians chapter 3 verse 5. Mortify, therefore, your members.
So it says, mortify, therefore, your members. Meaning, mortify, meaning kill, cast off, put away. Therefore, your members, read.
Which are upon the earth.
Which are upon the earth, come on.
Fornication.
These are the members. Fornication, come on.
Uncleanness.
Uncleanness, read.
Inordinate affection.
Come on.
Evil concupiscence.
Read.
And covetousness.
Covetousness, come on.
Which is idolatry.
Which is idolatry. So these are the members that Christ is referring to. Go back to Matthew 5, verse 29 again. To give some further clarity of what Christ was going into when he said, if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out. Read.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 29. And if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out.
Pluck it out. These members that you have in here, fornication, lasciviousness, inordinate affection, covetousness, which is idolatry, all these things, these sins are in you and they offend you. It's better that you get rid of them. So if you the brother that knows you deal with fornication and you know you deal with lasciviousness, a cell phone might not be something you can have.
Right.
Why? Because it's causing you to err. So you might need to be that brother that needs a flip phone. It is what it is. You might need to be that brother that all you got is a flip phone and all you can do is text and call. That is it. Because you know when you get on there, you got a porn addiction and you have wandering eyes. That's what Christ is going. If thy right eye offend thee, cut it off. Anything that is offending you, anything in your walk that you know, and you know, and we know ourselves, anything that is offending you that you know is going to cause you to sin, you're supposed to cut it off. These are those keys of endurance. This is that endurance to the end. These are the steps that you take to make sure that you make your calling and election sure, that you make you sure you are doing. Because a lot of times we like to get beside like, no, I'm good. I can deal with it. I'm strong. I can deal with it. And then you go and do the same thing that caused you to sin. You go through the same motions that cause you to sin. Maybe you need to apply what Christ said and change up the motions. Cut the motions off because that is what's causing you to err. Read on.
And cast it from thee, for it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell.
Because it's better that you get rid of that. You might not can be the brother that can go to the gym. For you, gym brother, and I ain't saying nothing wrong going to the gym. But if you know you the brother that has the wandering eyes and you deal with fornication and all this, the gym might not be for you. It might not be for you to go to the gym because you already know how it is. They be butt naked in the gym, basically.
Basically.
You be butt naked. That might not be for you because you know, damn, I'm going to be in here lusting and I'm going to mess around and go holler at one of these chicks and next thing you know, I'm going to be committing adultery. You know what? Hey, you know, it ain't that serious for me to go. I can work out at home. Mm-hmm. That has to be your thought process. Let the pride go. It don't matter if all the brothers going to the gym, so what? Hey, that ain't me. You have to let pride go and use enough wisdom to be like, you know what? Nah, I'm cool. That ain't me. I ain't going. That ain't me. Because you understand this is, I'm trying to get the kingdom. Now watch this. Drop that. Give me Galatians 5. Here's some more. Galatians 5, read verse 16. Endurance till the end. That is the goal for all of us. We all are striving to endure to the end. And the Bible left us keys for us to apply to our lives to make sure we make our calling and election sure. Galatians 5, started verse 16.
Galatians chapter 5, verse 16.
Come on.
This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
All of us in here, we must strive to walk in the Spirit that we don't fulfill the lust of the flesh. Watch this. Hold that. Give me Sirach 33 and 27. I'm going to show you something about that walking in the Spirit. And this is for you brothers and sisters that's always idle, that you always got idle time. Idleness breeds evilness, wickedness. And we're going to read it. Read that.
Sirach chapter 33, verse 27.
Come on.
Send him to labor.
Send him to labor. Come with. As you read up in the verse, he's referring to a servant. But we are all servants of the Lord in here. So it says, send him to labor.
That he be not idle.
That he be not idle. A lot of times the reason why many of us find ourselves caught up in pornography, caught up in drunkenness, caught up in whatever sin it might be that hangs you up is due to idleness. It's because we got too much idle time. Whether it be you brothers, you ain't doing it. It's always work to do in this truth. Mm-hmm. That's what we just read in Galatians. Walk in the Spirit. Walk in the Spirit that you don't fulfill the lust of the flesh. You should always be putting your hand to the plow to making sure you're walking. You're always keeping your mind going in the Spirit, whether I'm at this fire. Okay, because I understand brothers have to work. I understand we have jobs and things. But if you're that brother, you sitting at the house and you know damn well you can be at the Flyer Mission. You know you can be at Camp 101. You know you can be at camp. You know you the sister, you know you can be on the Titus 2 chat. You know you can be on the little sister reads that they be having. You know these things. But you choose not to do it and you choose to be idle and you wonder why you got so many issues. The scriptures say, send him to labor that he be not idle. Read.
For idleness teacheth much evil.
Do you hear what the Bible says? The Bible says idleness teacheth much evil. So with understanding that that's what the scriptures say, in our walk, in us trying to endure, we got to make sure that we don't be idle. We utilize all our time in making sure our calling and election is sure. And like I said again, I understand. I ain't talking about the brother that got to go to work. I ain't talking about the brother that you have real excuses as to why you can't put your hand to the plow. But if you that brother or sister that you got a million excuses, understand idleness teacheth much evil. And in my walk, 9 times out of 10, those are the spirits that have all the issues. Those are the spirits that end up walking right up out of here and not enduring. Now they're back in the world. These are the keys. These are the things that you meditate on to make sure that you endure. Go back. Galatians 5, read verse 16 again.
Galatians chapter 5, verse 16.
Come on.
This I say then, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
Listen to what Paul's saying. He says, walk in the spirit and ye shall not. It don't say maybe not. It don't say partially. It says, walk in the spirit and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Because watch this. What's the lust of the flesh? Jump down to verse 19.
Verse 19. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery.
Adultery. It's the same thing we read in Colossians 3 and 5. Same thing Christ was talking about with your members. Cut them off. It says adultery. Read.
Fornication. Uncleanness.
Read.
Lasciviousness. Idolatry. Witchcraft. Hatred. Variance. Emulation. Wrath. Strife. Sedition.
Come on.
Heresies. Envyings. Murders. Drunkenness. Revelings. And such alike.
And such alike. Come on.
Of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past.
Come on.
That they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
The people that do these things will not inherit the kingdom of God. Period. I don't care what your pastor tell you. So making sure that these things don't come upon you, he gave you the keys in verse 16. Walk in the spirit. And ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. I'm telling you, you wonder why Paul was moving and working like he was? Because he understood he battled with lust. So he kept his mind occupied in the work of the Lord. That's the same thing that we must do. Because we just read in Sirach where it says, idleness teacheth much evil. Now, last scripture, give me 1 Peter's, the 5th chapter. 1 Peter's, the 5th chapter and the 8th verse.
1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8.
Come on.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour.
So this is why we must make sure we be sober, we be vigilant, because Satan is like a roaring lion. He's going around seeking whoever he can devour. And guess what? He's looking for that brother or sister that's idle, because the idleness teaches much evil. He's looking for that brother or sister that can't quite seem to cut off that thing that's offending them. He's looking. So we, in our endurance in this truth, have to make sure we stay sober and we are vigilant. Vigilant means you take you have a special care. You watchful about you watching after your own soul. You have to be vigilant. Always watching, always circumspect, always on point, understanding Satan is like a roaring lion. He looking to catch you up. So with that, all praises to the Most High God. I pray y'all got some understanding from today's short topic. Shalom, Most High and Christ bless.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.